Today, in this video, I am going to disconnect my machine from the internet and going to run a model locally. Hi everyone, welcome back to the next video into the Ollama series, where we are trying to understand the concept of Llama in a step-by-step manner. And today, in this video, we are going to see how I can test and run a model locally. My name is Mukesh Kala. I am a 5x MVP certified solution architect and a LinkedIn top voice. Feel free to send a connection request. Happy to be part of your network. Into the previous videos of the playlist, we have already seen that what exactly is Llama, how do you download Ollama, how do you install it, how you pull, list, view, stop, delete, and copy the models, right? So with all of these context, now I believe you guys have Llama installed and you know how do you pull, list, view, and stop all of that. So today we are going to explore the next step is that once you have the model with you locally, how you can actually utilize that for your queries. In case you don't have any of this, I have hooked up the complete playlist link in the description. Feel free to refer that as well. Okay, so now I am back to my desktop, and now to get started with, first thing first is you need to go to the task menu and you need to have this icon here, which is the Ollama icon. That ensures that Llama is currently running on your machine. If you have already installed Llama and you are not seeing this icon, then just make sure that you search Ollama, click on that thing, and it will start this exe for you here like this. And now we are ready to launch our queries inside Ollama. Now to get started with, I'll go to the start menu and I will use something which is called Windows PowerShell. Open that screen, I'll maximize it, and you can just type a command which is Ollama dash dash version, and that should tell you that which version of Ollama you are using. In the last video, we have installed 0.9.3. Okay, now before you can run any of the command in Ollama, you need to make sure that you have installed some of the models, right? So in the last video, guys, we have already installed a model. To check which all model you are having into your Ollama, you can just use this command, which is Ollama space list, and that will give you these details, right? So 2 weeks ago, we have installed this model, which is Llama 3 latest. If you haven't watched the video, you can refer to the previous videos in the playlist. You will find the link in the description. And I have this thing, which is available, where I can now run this Llama 3 model, and I want to query this Llama 3 model by providing inputs from my machine. Okay. Now, before I proceed with this tutorial, what I want to do is I'll just go to my internet connection and I'll just disconnect it from my Wi-Fi. So as you can see that now I am not connected to the internet, and now whatever I make the queries, it should be coming from my local model, which is installed on my machine, right? So that was the whole thing we wanted to do today. Okay. Now, before I go to the next hands-on, I want to give you some concepts which as a LLM developer or an LLM user, you should be aware of, right? So this thing we have already seen that I can use Ollama dash dash version, and this gives me a version, and Ollama list give me all the list of the models which are installed on my Llama. Okay. Now, to start an interactive session where I say that where Llama model, I ask a question and Llama gives me a response, I can use this command, which is Ollama run followed by the model name. So for me, I have installed Llama 3 latest. Whatever model you have installed, you have to use that. What happens in the background when you actually go and launch this query? In the background, it launches something which is called REPL, which prompts, where prompts are submitted and AI response appear live. So when you run Ollama run this command, it launches REPL, where as a user you prompt something and you get the response. Now, you might be hearing this term for the first time, REPL, so that's why spending 1 minute here that what exactly is REPL. So REPL stands for read, evaluate, print, and loop. So REPL is a simple interface where as a user I can query, I will get a response, I'll read it, and then I can do the same thing again and again. In the terminologies of LLM, it stands for read, evaluate, print, and loop. Okay, just remember that. And why it is useful? Because it gives you an interactive feedback. And today we are also going to use the REPL of Ollama into the PowerShell. So it gives me an interactive feedback. You can write an instruction and the LLM responds immediately. It is good for iterative learning, beginners, all of us are trying to understand this. So REPL is a good interface. And whenever there is a new feature which is getting added, I want to debug, I want to learn something or explore some of these things, I can definitely go and utilize something which is called REPL, right? And to launch the REPL, the command which I have to utilize is this one, Ollama run latest, that will launch the REPL and we can then query the stuff. Okay, so I hope you understand what is REPL. Okay, so now back to the terminal and let's try to run this model, which is Llama 3 latest. For that, the command which we have to use is Ollama run, and you just have to specify the model name. In my case, that is Llama 3 colon latest. And you can still see that my machine is disconnected from the internet. There is no connection which is available. And now it has started the REPL session for me, where it is asking me that I can ask any questions here. Okay. Let's start with very simple. Maybe, who are you? And it says that I am just a language model. I don't have any personal identity. I exist solely. My primary function is this and all those details, right? So at least we are getting the response from an LLM. Okay. Now let's try to do some of the tasks. I have written a couple of prompts into my another screen, which looks like this, so that you guys know what I'm trying to do. So I have different kinds of criterias for testing this LLM, which is Llama, and I'm going to use all of these prompts one by one and you can just try it to do on your own. Okay, so the first one is I'm going to do something which is called translation into multilingual. So I'll just maybe copy and I'll just paste it, right? So where I say that, what should I pack for a beach vacation in summer, and I say enter, and here it is. And this is the response, right? A beach vacation in summer looks like this. You can have beach towel, sunscreen, sunglasses, water shoes, personal care items, and whatever you could ask, right? Now, I could also ask something like this, where I want it to translate something. Translate this to Hindi. The quick brown frog jumps over the lazy dog. And here is the Hindi, right? Which is Tej Bhuke Fox Ne Alse Kutte Ke Upar Lapeta. And then it says each and every, I would say the translation as well, right? That's cool. Now let's try to do some kind of reasoning. So I'm just going to paste a maths question, which is like this. Solve: a train travels 60 kilometers for 2 hours, then 40 kilometers for 3 hours. What is the total distance? And here is the answer. So basically what I'm testing now here is a reasoning and a problem solving. And it has done a pretty neat job by even explaining me all this problem in a step-by-step manner. Awesome, right? Let's try to write a poem. Maybe this. I'll just copy paste a prompt. Write a 4-line poem about sunrise over mountains. And that was quick, right? I can ask it something about jokes, right? So tell me a clean, family-friendly joke about computers. And here it is. Why did the computer go to therapy? Because it has a little glitch in its memory, right? So all of that you can also do, right? Now I can also use it to do the task like summarization. Summarize this and enter. And then it has summarized the text for me. Okay. Now you can also ask it some kind of technical concepts. Something like this, where I say explain what is a Python decorator in simple terms, right? So same like in any LLM, guys. Now if you would notice that I am running all of this from my local machine where I'm not connected to the internet, and this is what my model is responding. How cool is that, right? I hope you guys are able to follow along, right? Now what is the catch here? The catch here is this model which I am using, Llama 3 latest, is trained on some data from internet till some date. So it might not have latest information, which you might ask for 2025. So let's try to ask the model. Something like this, right? Till what date you are trained on? So you can see that it says that I was trained until December 2021. The training data includes all of these details. So basically anything which you ask from after December 2021, this model will not have the information. However, all the other things, which is like the general information, is available with the model. Good part about this model is it is running locally, and now I can train this model with my set of information, with my data, which is also known as context grounding, right? And then when I ask a question, it will have that information. So with Llama, the best part is you can also train this with your own information. That will park for the some other video. Today I just wanted to show you this information, that how you can utilize this model directly from the console, right? Isn't it great, right? Now let me show you something else. So you can just put a backslash and a question mark and hit enter onto the terminal, and it will show you some of the available commands, right? So set, show, load, save, clear, by, clear the session. To exit it, you just have to mention slash by and it will exit this REPL. So if I just say slash by, it has closed this thing and you are back to this thing, right? And as in the previous video, if I just type here, let's say Ollama PS, this is the model which is currently running, right? So Ollama 3 is running until 3 minutes from now. Now to stop that model, you just have to write Ollama and then stop. And because this command, the by command, only stopped the REPL. To stop the terminal, I'll just type here Llama 3 colon latest, and that stopped the model. Now if I again do Ollama PS, you would notice that I am not running anything, right? So that way you can actually exit the terminal by writing slash by. And to stop the model, you just have to use Ollama stop and this model. Again, if you want to run it, you can again use the same command which we have discussed at the beginning. Let me quickly show it to you. So when you go to the top, you have to use Ollama run to run the command, list to have the list, and version to list the version, right? So we have seen all of these different commands, and now your model is running locally on your computer. How cool is that, right? So that is, guys, that is what I wanted to cover in this video, that how you can actually utilize Llama with an REPL interface on PowerShell. I hope you guys are able to follow along this series. In the upcoming videos, what I plan to do is integrate it with applications like Python, RPA, do the context grounding and all of that stuff. But we want to do in a step-by-step manner, right? So for that, wrapping this video here, thank you for watching. Any more questions, any more doubts, feel free to write in the comments, or you can also drop me an email as well, right? So with that, wrapping this video here, I'll appreciate your feedback on the content and see you in the next video. Bye.